So let me begin today about one very interesting topic which helped us to learn a lot about this Dr. Shankaran's method. Let us go little slowly about the case taking part. This helps to understand where to go. If you know in case taking where to go, it becomes very, very easy. It is called level of experience. Some of you must have heard about it, but I would like to explain it with some cases, and this is really very, very, very helpful in practice when we take the case. There are 7 levels. In everywhere, like in music, sa re ga ma pa dha ni, 7 levels. So the 7 levels of experience are seen in many, many spheres, in music, in lot of all the music, including drums. These 7 layers are very important. Similarly, we have 7, like 7 oceans are there, very famous. Similarly, the 7 levels of experience are very, very important in case taking. If you know this, your case taking will be very, very easy. This is the best discovery of Dr. Shankaran. And the beauty is, even Dr. Jayesha prescribes on, he's also a very famous colleague, he mostly prescribes on past life experiences, about the meditation, etc. But in his taking also, he inquires about this experience, level of experience. Dr. Mahesh Gandhi, my another colleague, prescribes on plant remedy. But in his case taking also, he concentrates totally on the experience. So whoever is the successful doctor, whatever is the method, always we go for level of experience. And once you understand this, your case taking becomes very, very easy. I will elaborate with an example. First level of experience is name level, the diagnosis. For example, a patient is having prostate cancer. Nothing else, you cannot get any symptom except diagnosis, it is a prostate cancer. There is no other way, sometimes it can happen that patient is not at all cooperating, no symptoms, ask cravings, aversions, mind. Everywhere there is nothing, 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 everything normal, everything fine, I can't tell you, everything fine. If that type of case comes, nothing else except diagnosis, some doctors, normally we don't do like this way, can give sebal ceruleta on the diagnosis level. It is just the name level. But usually we don't do it like this way. So I'm describing a case, for example, patient comes to us with a chief complaint of headache. The main diagnosis is migraine or headache. It is called name level. Is it clear to all? This is called level 1. Is it clear? Second level is fact level. Level 2 is called fact. All the modalities, all the description of the chief complaint, aggravation, amelioration, associated for time modality, all modalities of the chief complaint is known as fact level. Is it clear? First is name, second is fact. This is called level 2. Next level is called emotional level. All the emotion, all anxiety, anger, irritability, jealousy, depressed, all comes under level 3. This is called emotion. For example, chief complaint is the migraine, level 1. Level 2 is aggravated in sun, aggravated overexertion, aggravated working in the computer, better by sleep. That is level 2. Level 3 is, it makes me feel very irritable, very angry. I don't feel like working. I feel like sleeping. I may lose the job. All are level 3. Many, many homeopaths prescribes on level 3. And we get lost into the story. We have to go much deeper in case taking. Level 3 we need to listen, but we should not get too much into the level 3. This is the biggest mistake we do. We should not prescribe on anxiety. It is a big rubric. It contains 500 remedy. We should not prescribe on just the anger. It contains again 500 remedy. We have to go deeper into the case. So first we listen, but this is emotional level. Next level is delusion. It is also called image level. It is also called dream level. So all dreams, image, delusion are level 4. It is very, very important when we go for this level. Image, for example, I feel because of so much headache, doctor, I feel as if I am trapped in a box. I can't come out. Just it feels like trapped in the box because of the headache. All my activities are hindered. So trapped in a box is a delusion. This is an image. Many of my junior doctors commit mistake, even many of my assistants, we mostly prescribe on the delusion. Moment patient says trapped in a box, you take the rubric delusion made up of in a box and you will give argentum nitrate. And again we commit a mistake. This is a delusion, this is an image. And what is the experience of the image? This question should be asked. What do you feel when you say trapped in the box? Describe it more. And what's the experience when you say trapped in a box? That is called sensation. This is level 5. This is very, very important. When you say you are hearing Dr. Shankaran every month, always he goes up to sensation level in every case. First he will inquire about the chief complaint, description, emotion, some image will come. He will not prescribe on the image. He will always inquire, what is your experience in that image? That is sensation. Not only that, the sensation will come in various places. Childhood nature, in dreams, in happiest incident, in worst situation, you will get the same sensation. And that runs usually through and through. So this is sensation. Are you getting me so far? Just go back to the screen. Yeah. Anyone didn't follow, please ask me. This is an interactive session. This is not a seminar, neither a lecture. I just want you to understand this so that your case taking will be very easy. So far, anyone who has not followed, please raise your hand and ask me up to this level. Clear? All of you followed what I mean so far? Yeah. Yes, tell me.
Differentiate between a delusion and a feeling.
Yeah, it is just a mechanical difference. Feeling is a term. Instead of feeling, we can put it as emotion also. And always we'll ask the question, what is your feeling in this situation? What is your feeling in this situation? So patient speaks only about the emotion, like anger, irritability, jealousy, not specifying anything deeper, no image at all. This is called emotional or feeling level. And when it comes with some image, I feel angry as if I want to outburst, as if I want to kill, as if I feel trapped, as if I feel hindered, as if I feel someone is torturing me, as if someone is killing me, someone is hitting me. When some image comes, that becomes a delusion. And experience in the delusion and the image is the sensation. So when you say feeling is just a word, you can replace it with emotion. This feeling has no importance. This doesn't mean only feeling. Very good question, but a simple mistake. Instead of feeling, if you are comfortable, normally, this is I'm using one of my assistant's PowerPoint. Usually I use the term emotion. I don't write feeling. I like level 3 is emotion. Best will be you correct. You make it level 3 as emotion, that will be better. Because feeling always we ask, every level we ask, what's the feeling, what's the feeling. Even at the sensation level also we can ask, what's the feeling. So best will be level 3. If Sneha, you are giving the PowerPoint, I suggest level 3 instead of feeling, you make it as emotion, that will be better. Clear? So now,
sir,
yeah.
Sir, still, if I have understood it, if I have understood it correctly, it is basically when the patient is giving a picturesque idea of the feeling that he is going through or the emotion that he is going through.
Some image, some picture.
Like I feel as if I want to hit that man.
Yeah.
That gives the image, picture.
Even for the right,
based on that we go to the experience of it.
Yeah. More better will be as if I am trapped in a cage, that type of example. As if I have kept in a box. As if a situation, so much turmoil, doctor, I feel as if an earthquake is going to happen. You know, doctor, few days ago, something happened in Nepal and I was at Calcutta. Even the buildings were shaking and I feel as if earthquake is going to happen, that much turmoil in my mind. This is an image. This is level 4. You should not repertorize this because we have to go little deeper level. If you just take the rubric, fear of natural calamity, calcarea kav is a good remedy, but this is wrong. This is not a sensation. This is just an image. And what is the experience in the image gives sensation. For example, I have a very good case, just comes to my mind, a prolapsed piles case. The chief complaint was as if 1,000 needle was biting in one point. This was the chief complaint. Very sharp, 1,000 needles were biting. Patient was showing like this way. Severe pain, doctor, while passing stool. An allopathic doctor said, operation is must. She said, I need to hold the toilet, some side thing. So much pain, doctor, so severe. And she said, it reminds me the Passion of Christ, where how Jesus Christ tolerate so much pain, that reminded me at one point, she said that. And everywhere she said, lot of things she has to do, like tornado is coming, it is hitting me very fast. Something is happening like a tornado in many situations where she had to shift. Suddenly something is coming and hitting me very fast. And then she had a dream where she is like a small ant and there is a huge piles of rice on her. And she was feeling very suffocated. And then she gave a very clear-cut image. Doctor, in many situations, I see I am above. Like an eagle, I am flying. And below me, the whole world is there. I feel trapped. I feel suffocated. But I love to see it from the above. And I love flying. Anyone would say it is a case of an eagle. This is an image. But I asked, what is opposite of this experience of flying? She said, it is choking, doctor. She just showed me this gesture. It is choking, suffocating, throttling, cannot move. It is a very strong feeling of suffocation. So, flying was not much energy. Everywhere there was strong feeling of suffocation, choking, throttling. Main center of action was throat. And at one point she said, doctor, in my wife, my own happiness, she is a very big worker in Amway. She earns so much, more than 2 lakhs of rupees, and she can travel all over the world. She is a very famous, excellent worker for Amway. But she says, doctor, my family and duty is the priority. I want to travel, but I cannot, because my responsibility and duty is always priority than my own happiness. This was the split. This is the split between own happiness versus duty. And she has very distinct dream of snakes with the Naga. And she feels Naga is protecting her. That is her Kul Devata, etc., etc. And everywhere this choking, suffocation was very strong. Everywhere victim aggressor was very strong. And everywhere there was Dubida between her own happiness versus her duty. What is the remedy? What is the remedy I'm asking you? What's the remedy in this case?
Lack humanum.
No.
Lack humanum.
No. Close, very close. Suffocation is there, dreams of snakes.
Naza.
Naza, the Indian cobra has the split between own happiness versus the responsibility. Delusion suffered wrong is the main rubric. So Naza, within a very short time, cleared her prolapsed pile completely. And she is doing fantastically well. Even at one point, she connected with the snake and the Jesus Christ. She said, the village stories, if there is a snake bite, the same snake comes and sucks the blood. In the whole process, snake dies. but the victim survives. And she again connected it to the story of Jesus Christ, how Jesus suffered himself, but so many people he gave, you can say, salvation or relieve the pain, etc. So this is the way everything gets connected with the remedy. And she did fantastically well, even a surgical case, responding very well with NASA. So what I was trying to say, her delusion was of birds, but the experience was of suffocation, choking, which was running through and through. That is sensation. Another very important point of sensation will be kingdom gets differentiated at sensation level. I'm going to speak little later, just after this slide, I will elaborate it. Plant kingdom, mineral kingdom, animal kingdom, this whole idea gets separated or gets cleared at the sensation level, not at the chief complaint level, not at the fact level. At the sensation level, we need to observe whether it is a sensitivity or reactivity, whether it is victim aggressor, or whether it is mineral sensation structure problem. I will just elaborate it in the next PowerPoint. When patient is describing the sensation, we have to observe the energy. For example, this is very clearly observed in children. Suddenly, a small child gets terrified. A dog is just a small Pomeranian, but the child says too much fear, terror, shrieking with the fear, and just expression of running here and there. This is the expression of solanacy, where terror and the energy is flying. Flee from fright. When there is a fright, you are just flying. Obviously, this is the energy of solanacy, like belladonna, ostramonium. Or if you see too much restless, hyperactive, loving with the dance, here and there, too much attention seeking, loves music, jumping here, jumping there, not at all sitting for a 1 minute. Again, in a small child, this is the energy of tarantula. Or the case which I said, the sensation choking, this was the hand gesture. We observed the energy. Doctor, something was choking me here, right here. I couldn't breathe. It was suffocating. This is the hand gesture in a sensation of NASA case. Or if I've got a case of anacardiasis, hand gesture. Doctor, I feel stuck, stiff. My knee joint, I feel something is just clamped. I cannot move at all. Knee joint is very fixed, stiff. This gesture. And if I move for some time, I can move it. This is the hand gesture. So when sensation is described, usually it is described with hand gesture, energy, the whole body pattern. This we have to observe. This is called energy. Usually sensation comes with some hand gesture, and we need to observe on this hand gesture. Amruta, just whatever comes spontaneously about this hand gesture, give example, one or two. Whatever cases you have seen. Amruta, hum log focus kar sakta hai kya? No, we have to focus it. 1 second. Amruta, maybe you have to come here or something. Mic, theek hai, mic low. Amruta is myself, Dr. Shankaran's other song resident. She manages our cases. So just spontaneously, I'm telling her to describe some hand gesture.
Hello. So hand gesture plays a very important role. If you are very, very vigilant in the case and you are there observing the patient, you will sometimes realize that whenever they use a very important word or action, suddenly there is intense energy and then a hand gesture is seen. You know, and there you have to be very vigilant to capture that. Because in most of the cases, you will see the same hand gesture sometimes getting repeated. For example, I remember one of Sir's cases. She said when she had diarrhea, you know, the stool just is just forced out, you know, like this. And this was a hand gesture. Maybe we just made a note of that. Usually whenever there is energy and hand gesture, we just have to make a note of this, that these were the points where we had observed. And secondly, in her life space, what she experienced was that she felt in her family or within her society, because of some family issues, she felt her family was excluded And she again made this hand gesture as if they were just excluded from the rest of the society because of some caste problem or something. So when we saw this energy, the hand gesture coming again and again, it helped us, you know, to come to a point. And I remember the chief complaint what she had, she has IBS and she would get diarrheas mostly in the rainy season. And secondly, another chief complaint what she had was every time any strong odor, and she said especially the odor of eggs make her, you know, vomit or she gets nausea. And then we just knew the remedy that it was a colchicum case, and this particular sensation of Lily Flore family of being extruded from the society. So this helped us to, you know, anchor the case. So yes, hand gestures are very, very important. This was one case which came to my mind when sir asked me.
So in many cases, this hand gesture is very important. I had a very good case long back when Dr. Shankaran discovered sensation. That time, just in short, I will tell you the importance of this hand gesture. I had a case of a diabetes mellitus, but that was the chief complaint. And maximum energy of the case was, he was a actually crew, Indian Airlines crew, and he mostly flies, but he loves to play badminton. He said badminton is like a no, like an item, like a temple. It is a no-go item for me. It is like visiting a temple. And patient had maximum energy in this playing badminton. And in short, if I have to say this, he loves to play badminton and he loves to smash. That was his energy. He loves to smash. How to deceive the opponent while playing badminton? I will behave as if I am playing the ball here, but I am playing it there. And how to deceive the opponent and playing very swiftly, very quickly, subtle, the flexible body, the very subtle body movement, that was very, very special affinity for him. In his dream, that is image level, he had a feeling that he is driving a motorcycle, particular brand he said, just now I don't remember those days. He is driving a motorcycle and he gets a macho feeling. He is just pressing the accelerator, he is driving very fast and police is chasing. And he is just deceiving the police and running very fast. So I observed in the dream there is a victim aggressor, there is a deceit. And then he said he loves Animal Channel in National Geography, especially when cheetah attacks the prey. And what he likes most was the at the last moment when cheetah runs and the deer runs, at the last moment, or a buffalo runs, the cheetah just gives a this type of movement, this type of just a movement at the hind leg of the animal, like a big buffalo or antelope or the deer. And deer topples down. And he said, the maximum energy he is having at one point, he is concentrating and giving this movement with energy. And then he started laughing. Ha, ha, ha. It reminds me how I play badminton and the way I smash it, this connection. So it was my 20 years ago case when Dr. Shankaran discovered sensation method and patient did very well with cheetah's blood remedy. This will be too much just now for you. But this is the importance of the hand gesture. Same hand gesture what he enjoys playing badminton, same energy he connected in universe with the energy of the cheetah. And he responded so well. Anyway, that is too much now because there is no supported rubric. That was purely from the system. Now energy we spoke with the hand gesture. And the last level, this level 7 is very, very interesting for me. Actually, it is called no name or the witness level. It is called the script. When patient is giving the case to me and I am hearing, both are connected on one blank screen. This is called witness. Actually, there is a vital force within the patient who wants to heal. And doctor also wants to cure the patient. And this is from my experience, I can say. Even the Tagore song, you are from Calcutta, if you know, if someone is Bengali, that Bishwo Sathe Jethay Amar Jog, সেইখানেতে আমার যোগ তোমার সাথে দ্য মিনিং ইজ with the universal energy with which you are connected, I am also connected there. And from this connection, we can prescribe very accurately. Patient gives the history, we receive the case, and something happens in the universe. If you are really concentrating, you are enjoying the sound health, vital force encourages the patient, as Hanuman said, signs and symptoms he describes nicely. And if you are in tune with someone, as Gita says, results are not in our hand, but we can try our best. So if you just concentrate, whatever best we can do, someone else does his work through us. This is the secret of success. Actually, we are not the doer. Doer is someone else. But the seventh level plays a very important role. I am not talking about the religion. I am talking about the universe. The seventh level, how universe does his work through us. To reach that seventh level plays a very, very important role. Are you with me? Are you getting me? Bumper, kya you are following? Amrita khali, oh, AC chalu karana, mujhe ye nahi chahiye. Kya hua? Kuch samajh mein aaya kya bumper? Speak. The seventh level is the no name. It is called witness level. So far, no name is given. It is the blank screen on which we are taking the case. Patient is writing his script. Even I am understanding from this level. This is common between the patient and the me. And this is a common connection where the universal energy, or you call so-called God, where patient is connected with the God or universal energy, I am also connected with him or her. In that level, and in that level, case is getting solved. Are you with me? Are you following or no?
So I have a question. Is it that this level, the sixth, the seventh level that we are talking about, is it a level where the patient has completely surrendered? And I have perceived the patient as a doctor so much so that we are all in sync with that. One common process of healing. Is it so?
Not exactly. Even if patient doesn't surrender,
even if much in sync with the patient.
Yeah, that willingness to heal is very important. Patient may not surrender. It is automatic. It is an automatic witness level. The script, a blank script. Suppose you are telling me, now you are telling me, is it surrender? So I'm not writing anything, but there is a blank script. Suppose you are my patient. So you are telling, is it surrender? And I'm thinking, both the planes are working in the universal energy level. That is seventh level. Even if the connection is the most important, where you are connected with the universal energy, I am connected with the universal energy, so automatically there is a connection between you and me. This is most important in seventh level. You are connected with the universal energy, I am also connected. So automatically myself and yourself are also connected. So at this level, if we can go, case-taking becomes complete and really we can heal. If we just understand also, sometimes even without remedy, that is the secret of success. Just listen to the patient and take the case up to this level. 2 days ago, I had a very deep pathology of a young teacher had malignancy. And he was telling all about how brilliant student he is and he loved being a teacher. His both the parents were teacher and he's just a math teacher. And how he motivates students and how he likes creativity, and in spite of metastatic cancer, he's still a teacher going to college. And everywhere he says, hurdles comes in life, but I prove it. I love challenges and I prove myself. Everywhere this hurdle and prove. And then he said, doctor, after revealing my whole story to you, I feel I've already started healing. This is seventh level. I understood him from the point of view of system, from the point of view of my knowledge. That was my understanding. He revealed, and something universe did it, so that after revealing the whole case, he started feeling, doctor, I've already started feeling healing and energetic. This is seventh level. It has no name. Actually, many times it is not spoken, not mentioned. But from my experience, I have seen that whenever we get connected properly with that universal source, let us say God, if it is there, or if you are an atheist, say universal energy, where you are connected with that universal energy, something happens through him to us and to the patient so that we can reach up to that level. This is, in my understanding, the witness level or no name level. We cannot put it any name here. This is connection with the universal energy. Clear? You need not bother. When you take the case, it happens automatically.
Yes.
When you take the case, don't try to bother. Where is the witness level? I have to go to the witness level. I have to go to the no level. Not at all. This happens spontaneously, automatically, and very easily. When you are having the spirit, when you start the new case in your mind, when you say, just you pray yourself, inner God, I will do my best to help the patient. And patient is in front of you. Patient also must be thinking, I will do my best to give the good history to the doctor. And then automatically both of us get connected and a good history is obtained. The screen on which the good history is obtained is called 7-level. It is an automatic process. You need not bother about it. In case taking, you need not bother about it at all. Now, with an example, I would like to elaborate a little more about the level of experience. Say level 1, we are describing a mountain, a Himalaya, say. Level 1 sees mountain and he wants to know its name. What is the name of the mountain? Say Himalaya. This is level 1. Level 2 wants to know its dimensions and facts. How high it is, say 29,000 feet. From east to west, from where it is going, which color mostly it is, the description of the mountain, it is higher than all the other mountains, etc. All are called facts level. This is called level 2, like something like modality. The description about the mountain is called fact level. Next is level 3, all the emotions, for example, it reacts with the feeling of happiness, joy, opposite of which is grief and sorrow. When I look at the mountain, I feel joy, I feel happy. What's the opposite feeling? Very sad. If I go away from the mountain, I feel sad, a kind of grief. These are emotional level, level 3. Level 4, how does it feel when you look at the mountain? It feels like I am flying in the air. It is an image. It is level 4. It feels like flying in the air. This is typically an image. You are not actually flying, but you are feeling like flying in the air. This is a delusion. What's the feeling there? What is your experience when you are flying in the air? Experience of level 5 is it feels like light and floating. So, experience of level 4 is sensation. It feels light and floating. Opposite may be heavy. What is the experience of this level? Energy, maybe hand gesture will come. Experience is like going up and opposite is going down. It is too heavy. It is weighing me down. This is the hand gesture. Say example, Hamamelidae family, if you know, the cannabis family, where the main sensation is something heavy is weighing me down and I want to be free. I want to float, etc., etc. So, the experience of level 5 is sensation, and the sensation, experience of level 5 is energy, and energy is expressed with lot of hand gesture. Now, very important levels in follow-up. How patient describes this level in follow-up? Because if you prescribe the remedy at the level of sensation, in follow-up also you will observe what are the changes. For example, level 1 will say blood sugar is improving. This is diagnosis. Level 2 will say pain in the knee is better. It is more specifying. Now I can move. Pain in the knee, modalities are better. Level 3 will say he feels better on the whole and is happier and less irritable. Changes in the mind. Level 4 will say, he does not feel in a tunnel anymore. When you prescribe the remedy, patient was feeling he was in a tunnel. After giving the remedy at the image level, patient is no more feeling in the tunnel. At the level 5, that is at the sensation, heaviness is much less. I no longer feel heavier. That is much less. Sensation is better. At level 6, we'll say he feels more energetic and can now bounce up and down. This is energy level gesture. I can bounce up and down. And level 7, we don't observe any change here. It is again the no name or witness level. At this level, usually we don't see any change. This is a very silent script on which we are writing, so no need to observe any change here. Little bit more elaborating so that you will understand it clear. Level 1 is the name level. Some doctors I know prescribe only on the diagnosis, say diabetes mellitus, and you want to give cizicium zambodium on that. This is called prescription on level 1. Question, what exactly is happening? If you are taking the case, what exactly is happening? Level 2, fact. What? There are three parts in the fact. That is the fact level, very, very important. What it is? Qualified fact, location, sensation, modality, concomitant. It should be a complete symptom as regard to the above 4. And whenever you are taking any case at any level, very, very important is what is the peculiar symptom? How does he differ from others? How does he identify? How can you identify how he is separate from the other? So PQRS symptom is very, very important at any level. For example, today morning also we had an interesting case. Again, I will tell you. Amruta, just tell the today morning's case of that malignant. Yeah, what was the very peculiar symptom you got it while doing CRS? Speak. This case we did it 2 hours ago. It was a case of malignancy, no?
Yes. So today in the morning we had a case of almost post-menopausal woman, and it was a post-op case of cancer cervix. And we took all the current symptoms what we observed right now. In the past, she said there was very interesting thing which happens with her. This female had gone through a lot of griefs in her life. There were many, many deaths in her family of her close one, loved ones. And anytime there's a severe grief or sad news, what happens is this sudden clenching of the teeth. The teeth are just clenched together, and at the same time, there's closing of the eyes. The whole body goes kind of lifeless. She is alert, she is not unconscious, and it's not even like an epileptic fit, but this sudden clenching of the teeth, closing of the eyes, and the whole body as if there is no energy, and there is constant involuntary crying at that time, and she doesn't realize what's happening, and she had to be, you know, supported that time. So this was very interesting phenomena which sir and I observed, which we saw in the case, and we also found this very interesting rubric in the repertory. We could not exactly find clenching of the teeth, but we found face, jaw, clenching, grief from, and there were only 3 remedies in that rubric. And surprisingly, Ignatia, which we were thinking very strongly, this was also covered by Ignatia. So when you qualify the fact, see, if you see at a very broad level, we could have just taken ailment from grief or ailment from death of the parent or loved ones. But when you qualify it or you go more deeper into it, more specific, what you can get is absolutely beautiful rubrics which will help you in your prescriptions. And when you qualify the fact, in this case, we found out that the totality of the grief or the whole syndrome that happens to her at the time of grief, if we considered only that portion, for example, weeping involuntary, ailment from death, or this kind of spasms after grief or face clenching jaw with excitement, Ignatia was one remedy which came up very strong. So that is a very important to go more sharper, to be more specific in your questions so that you get the clear particulars in your case taking.
Yeah. Why I remembered that case was, it was very peculiar, and she had 5 deaths in the family. She lost her father, mother, younger brother due to accident, and she was strong brooding over the grief. Those were okay. If you see repertorize, even sepia was coming. But very, very peculiar fact was clenching teeth, emotions after. That rubric had only 3 remedy, and Ignatia was one of the strong remedy, and everywhere Ignatia was coming very strongly with brooding, grief, ailments from emotional upset, shock, indifference, many, many things were very clearly there. But the confidence with which I could stick to that Ignatia was this peculiar symptom, which was as if teeth was clenching, grief from or emotions from. So how do you feel? How does this affect you? These are the questions of the level 2. In everywhere you can ask the patient, tell me about that, wherever you went, emotion, just tell me about that, and what's your feeling? This is a very simple, easy question. And what is the effect of the chief complaint which affect you? Our favorite question is, what is the chief complaint? At one point we ask, what is the effect of this complaint on you? Level 3 is emotion, what? Again, feeling qualified, location, sensation, modality, concomitant. And what is very peculiar emotion? Always we go for what is very peculiar. And standard question we ask about level 3 is some fear, childhood nature, some worst situation in life. These are very, very helpful in case taking. What is the worst situation in your life and how you cope up? That really helps to understand the patient. And also, I will ask you, very important in case taking is about childhood nature. You must ask, how was your nature as a child? And I will ask you the question, why it is so important?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Reply, please.
Yes. So as we grow up, our feelings, emotions all get masked.
Yeah.
They start becoming little artificial, they get adjusted to the situation circumstances. But if we really have to get to the basics,
yeah,
is this childhood emotions, childhood feelings, which are most important, the way we react and respond in childhood.
Yeah, excellent. I have nothing to add, perfect answer. So you will observe when Dr. Shankaran at one point will always ask, how was your nature as a child? This is uncompensated. We cannot compensate it anymore. So this is very important to know childhood's nature. Even hobby interest, as I said, the badminton. I solved the case from badminton itself. This I've already described about the level 3 question. Maybe this PowerPoint, Sneha will give it to all of you. No need to copy it now. One situation in life which had a big effect on you. How did you feel like? Or what was the worst situation in your life? Is a favorite question at this level. Level 4, delusion. What is the situation? An image? How? How experienced and a dream? All dreams, all imagination, all delusions are particularly level 4. I will just give you today morning one follow-up I got it. One particular assistant commissioner, my very old patient, suffering from diabetes, and he had renal failure with creatinine 2.9 or something. He's taking allopathic medicine, Lasix, for that. But he had, at the old age, tremendous hallucination that he is feeling, very sorry to say, very funny, very interesting, that someone is coming. It happened like this way. He was actually, one day he was an assistant police commissioner, and one day from society someone came and said, we must put some webcam into our society. And that triggered his emotion. All the time he is feeling someone is coming to his house and raping his wife and the maid servant. And he is having a strong delusion that I can see some man is sitting on my wife and as if raping. This is very, as if he will think Alzheimer's. But I asked him, what is your experience in that situation? This was a level 4 delusion, as if someone is raping my wife and my maid servant. A 80 years gentleman is talking this vulgar. I can't trust my wife because she is like a prostitute behaving. This is a delusion, hyoscyamus. But I asked, uncle, what is your experience? Because he is my very, very old patient, very well-known patient. So I asked, uncle, what is your experience in this situation? He said, you know, I am a police commissioner. It is my duty to protect the society. It is my duty to protect my wife. It is my duty to protect the servant. And very, very egoistic person, lot of anxiety about family. He was not getting sleep at all. It was very difficult to manage him. Whole family members were actually standing on the toes. Allopathic medicines were not helping. Just a one dose of Nicolum 200. Last 1 week, he's having fantastic sleep. He has come down. This is from system. Nicolum is in the row 4. It is in the 10th column. And the main feeling of Nicolum is, I am a policeman. I have to protect the society. On this experience of the delusion, I could give Nicolum and very good results. This is the difference between prescribing on the delusion and prescribing on the experience. Are you following? Again, this I have covered. What are you showing with the hand gesture? At one point when we are at the sensation level or the hand gesture, what is your experience in that situation at the image level? This is called sensation. Question should be, what is your experience in that situation? Dr. Shankaran's very favorite question. All of us, whether it is Dr. Jayesha, Dr. Mahesh Gandhi, myself, anyone, even Dr. Divya, here all are connected. We always understand what is the deepest experience in a situation. All situations are stories. For example, if there is a death in a family member, everyone will feel very sad, very grief. Someone will feel, why God has done to me? Why God has punished me? That is someone's experience. Someone will feel suffered wrong. Someone can feel, I must take revenge. I will be desperate. I will feel others also should do something like this, should experience like this. So what is your experience in the situation? Here person to person differs. And this is here we can individualize a case. And also another favorite question, if patient is showing the hand gesture, what you are showing with the hand? We had a good case, I remember with Sneha, I did it long back, where particularly patient in short felt like something is protecting me. One hand like this way, another hand. And ultimately, there were 2-3 cases. One case, I gave sea turtle, where patient felt everything. I feel very safe if I withdraw myself into that particular shell. And lot of thing with a very, very sensitive about the knife and cutting with the knife and lot of reptile quality. Maybe I have given this case. If you can go to the site, maybe Sneha will guide you. hpathy.com in the present article, I've given a very good case and I've explained the level of experience. So you just afterwards we'll give you one web link. You can go to the hpathy.com and see my case of sea turtle. You will like it. All the examples of case taking, levels of experience will be very clear. So observing the hand gesture. Level 5 is the sensation. Here I want to speak. At level 5, that is the experience of the image sensation, kingdom gets differentiated. We have to see at this level whether patient is talking about victim aggressor, patient is talking about sensitivity and reactivity, or patient is talking about something to do with the structure. At sensation level, kingdom gets differentiated, not at very superficial level. I will just elaborate one short case at this level. Again, my very old case and I got very good result. One of the case with sleep apnea. One of the follow-up patients said, doctor, I want to tell you something, you know, which is something like psychological. I said, okay, come. I gave some time to the patient. Patient said, doctor, it is an image or something like experience, I don't know. But every night I feel someone is sitting on my chest and putting pressure. You can take a rubric here. Delusion, someone is sitting on the chest and putting pressure. only remedy is Kali Bitch. This is on the rubric level. I didn't do that. I said, tell me about more. He said, doctor, many times I feel as if a fish out of water, and just he described hand gesture, very casual talk, I feel as if fish out of water and struggling for oxygen. I said, okay. Then he was describing about acidity a lot. At one point I asked, just tell me a fish out of water, which is called non-human specific. Mineral kingdom will use it, animal kingdom will use it, plant kingdom will use it. So I said, just describe fish out of water. What do you mean? He said, it is suffocating. And when someone sits on my chest, I feel suffocating. Describe suffocating. It is someone is sitting on my chest and putting pressure. Tell me more. I feel suffocated. Tell me more. I feel something is choking with hand gesture. Tell me more. I feel I can't breathe. I want oxygen. He was excited. He was a Bengali patient. He said, I feel no oxygen. I want air. He started shouting. I said, tell me more. You want air. It is choking, doctor. It is choking. I want air. It is a desperate situation. I have just described little more. You are doing very well. I want air. I said, tell me little more. He said, lot of pressure inside, lot of pressure. I can't breathe. I need oxygen. This is called source word. Oxygen is coming. He can't breathe. He is choking. There is no animal word. Like someone is doing is not coming. He said, I can't breathe. I need oxygen. And then he said, I want to come out desperately. In that situation, I want to come out. This is typical feeling of oxygen where connection with the source oxygen is describing as if during the womb, the child wants to come out and child wants oxygen, a desperate situation towards the delivery where you need oxygen and you want to have your first independent breath. And I gave oxygen 1 mg few doses and patient did fantastically well. Sleep apnea got cured like a magic. But every case you cannot give oxygen of a sleep apnea. Here his image was very clear. His image was he felt that after retirement he wants to stay separately from his daughter and wife. He wants to be independent. In his dream, he had dreams of robbers where he was losing money, etc. These are all mineral theme. And he was very violent, very angry. And with lot of hand gesture, he said, I want oxygen. I am unable to breathe. I want to come out. This was a beautiful case of oxygen for me. Just prescribed on the sensation level, noting the hand gesture. Are you with me so far? Any question? Energy is represented by the way it moves. Energy is common to all kingdoms. Energy of any substance is that which is common to that substance and to the entire universe. At any point you can go to level 2 to level 5. From the fact level, straight away you can go to sensation, you can go to image. There is no fixed rule that you have to go step by step only. For example, patient may say, I am feeling trapped. In that trapped only, patient may say, trapped is an image, and in that image you can see lot of energy. I want to come out with this energy. May not be sensation, but straight away gesture. Or the fact level, doctor, I feel headache. In that headache, I feel someone is hammering me. Doctor, it is just a headache. Then patient may say, doctor, in many situations in life, someone is hitting me with a bamboo. Straight away, patient goes from level 2 to level 4. And what is your experience? I feel beaten up. I feel so lame, bruised feeling. This is the sensation of composite. One more potency selection, as today is my topic. First, we have to see whether it is a local or general. Is it the chief complaint at the headache level or patient as a whole is suffering? It is very important to generalize a complaint. If the person is feeling sensation locally or generally, often the sensation is the same, but where he feels, it determines the potency. What I mean? Potency is selected according to what level patient is experienced daily. Every case, when Dr. Shankaran takes the case or I take the case, will go up to sensation. But usually, as you said, patient is not describing much, only telling the fact. Then this is called level is fact level. I will tell you the potency. Usually, if patient gives lot of images, it is delusion level. When you are talking with the patient, if patient has lot of hand gesture and lot of energy, it is called energy level. So, if patient is only describing the diagnosis, nothing else, like prostate cancer, nothing else, if you want to prescribe, better to give 6 or 12. If it is only modality, in a case, aggravation, initial motion, better by continuous motion, aggravation at night, better by movement, better by warmth, chilly patient, aggravation, rainy season, you want to give Rustox, give 30, that will work better. Because no mind, no sensation, no dream, just the fact. Only emotion. I feel angry, I feel like striking, I feel like hitting, I am very sensitive to injustice, give Stapisagria 200. Because this is only emotion, mostly patient is at emotional level. If patient comes with an image, I feel I am insulted, I feel I am humiliated, I feel I am small, I feel he is the big taller one and I am the small one. Straight away patient gives this image, I feel insulted, humiliated, this is called level 4, give 1 m. If you get sensation level case, very clear, clear cut sensation, as I gave in oxygen, say, I feel suffocated, I feel choked, I want to come out, I want oxygen, I can't breathe, with lot of hand gesture, very easily patient going there, a knife patient, this is sensation level, give 10 m. And if case is at energy level, 50 m, but mostly we don't give it. In our practice, we mostly give to 1 m, 10 m. One Dr. Maganlal Patel from Gujarat, he wrote a beautiful book on coma. He used to give 50 m and cm in many coma cases, and he got good result. That is the only experience I have from him, but usually we give up to 1 m, 10 m. So every case we go up to the level 5, level 6, but usually whatever patient's level, we give that. If patient talks of only emotion, we give 200. If patient talks of more of sensation, energy, dreams, lot of image, we give 1 m. Repetition of the dose, whenever, usually I can tell you from Dr. Shankaran's experience, in a chronic case, usually we repeat once a month, till patient is at least 80% better. This is very simple, I am telling you. Otherwise, if patient is already much, much better, no need to repeat. Whenever the symptoms come back and there is an indication of the state, for example, in a dream patient is terrified, dream state is very clear, you can give 1 m, you can repeat. So very simple rule what Hahnemann said, as long as patient is better, no need to repeat. Repeat it whenever the improvement ceases. But in very chronic case like arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, severe backache, bronchial asthma, etc., usually we see in a chronic case, first few months, once a month repetition automatically comes. This is the average way of repetition. Shall I show you a short case? Do you have 5 minutes more? Child was brought by parents, craving for ice cream, milk, chicken, prawns, fish. Very spontaneously cravings came. Aversion to onion, vegetables, egg, yuck. Thirstless. Child becomes angry when hungry. These cravings, etc., general symptoms. Angry when hungry is a level 3. Perspiration scanty. Thirst increases before attack. Tendency for asthma, needed frequent nebulization every 15 days. Aggravation, change of climate, dust, smoke, moisture, level 2. Child loves to draw, loves music, loves painting. She can draw for 2 hours. Mother is always there in her picture. She is in her dreamland. She goes into her imaginative phase. Overexcited by rhymes, loves appreciation and very loquacious. She creates many stories related with mother and the wild animals. Afraid of many things, at one point she said, lion will not eat. Suddenly she said, tiger is not going to eat me. She's very creative, has own fixed ideas, ability to dream. She does not draw what her drawing teacher says. Imaginative face with animals, moon, stars, talks with moon. Afraid of darkness, cannot look at it, closes the door. Afraid of ghost, says there is somebody there. Clings to mother or father. Very afraid of noise, inquisitive, theorizing, creative. Very sensitive to suffering of others, like beggar in the signal. Suddenly she says, when I inquired about the dream, bear opens his mouth, picked me in a cage, paws out. Bear is going to eat me, so scared, needs blanket to hide, needs a stick to hit him. If you hear him, that will be hear her, that will be very interesting. I observed she was making stories out of it. Mother's pregnancy history. Some Guruji assured that you will have a baby soon, and she used to get dream of Gautam Buddha, Sunil Gavaskar, Mahatma Gandhi, Mother Teresa, etc. Gautam Buddha dream had a strong impact in her. Her mother said something good will happen to the child. She also have a delusion grandmother is talking with her. Father's nature is a poetry lover who is a scientist. Now just observe, due to technical reason, we may not show you the direct video, but listen to her.
संहिता कालपण तुला घाबरून परवा स्वप्न काय पडलं
सांग
मला. दिस इज इंटरेस्टिंग. शी इज डिस्क्राइबिंग अ ड्रीम, बट आई ऑब्जर्व व्हाट शी सेज इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टंट, हाउ शी सेज इज इम्पॉर्टंट.
पहिलं की मी एकटे जंगल मध्ये आहे आणि वाघ हळूहळू येतोय माझ्याजवळ खायला.
तुला ट्रान्सलेट करणं मराठी दे, मे नॉट अंडरस्टँड.
Hello. Yeah. So this kid is explaining her dream. Mother says she woke up last night scared, and she's saying she is in a jungle and there's a lion, a tiger, which is coming towards her, and she makes that roaring sound.
Ani kay zala? Priya Shaskar, in the dream
nantar kay zala, kay zala pude?
Nantar mo tenni mala khayla to ready hota.
So she says that the tiger is almost ready to eat her up, and she goes behind as the tiger comes towards her. Here she says, I think she turns around and she says there's another tiger on the other side, and she's between the two tigers.
So here we can take the rubric, say fear of tiger, fear of animal, delusion animal, but no, something more we have to observe.
Okay, now she says that she took two guns and she pointed the guns to them, and then she was going behind, and there she, we can observe a lot of energy, she almost started moving there.
Then she says there is a tiger and the lion both.
Yes.
What was her expression? Any change in her expression during sleep?
I was not in sleep.
I like that she will look.
You're scary. And next day morning, same thing she's told you.
I did not ask her, okay? Every day I have to ask
her. This was the dream. Then in the follow-up, little bit more, just observe her nature. I'm just making little fast-forward.
Except February alone.
Good.
I'm talking with the mother, she wants to speak. 30 days of September and April, June and November, she is trying to draw my attention.
March, April,
you gave him the last medicine. I'm just giving one special dose just now. You're supposed to come when the course is over.
March, April, May.
She will do very well. Thanks for coming.
April, May, March.
Tell me, how is she?
No, she is absolutely fine. She has changed her behavior a lot. She was very short-tempered. Mm-hmm. But now she has changed.
Mm-hmm.
And she was very particular about her eating habits, but now she has changed a lot. If I tell her that you have to eat only dal and rice, she eats that.
Not only her asthma changed, later on I will tell you which remedy I gave. She had typical craving for prawns, non-veg, tasty food. After the right remedy, there is also change. Now she can take dal rice. Her asthma was much, much better, hardly any attack. Only one minor attack happened, and since the first dose itself, she did fantastically well. We hear a little more.
Before, what was the thing?
No, she was very particular. I want prawns today, I want this today. She was pure non-vegetarian, but now she has changed a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Now she eats some vegetables or salads,
mm-hmm.
Only dal rice also she eats.
Mm-hmm.
If I tell her today I don't have time, say that you just have a chapati and milk.
One continuous 10 days.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because that is a coastal area,
mm-hmm.
And because of humidity also this asthma also starts. But
that was also good,
mm-hmm.
But the people kept some farm animals there.
Mm-hmm.
And she was playing with dogs and all, but she didn't have any problem over there.
Mm-hmm.
I gave one toast to him, two toast day, I don't pet dog.
Mm-hmm. Tell me
a
about
bitch, this. A bitch day.
Yesterday's experience about the principal.
So she was.
And what did she say? She is an artist.
She's an artist.
Now she's just describing her drawing.
What you have drawn? They are all going to America, and she is packing a bag.
Mm-hmm.
This girl.
Mm-hmm.
And even she is just out for going there.
Why they are going to America?
Because they live closer in London, they only live.
But why they are going to America?
They want to see America.
So simple four pictures are there, but she is describing about packing, going to London, going to America.
Switzerland, India, Kashmir,
no,
Himalaya.
They are staying in Agra, but they are going to search their car.
In America?
Yes.
Why? Because they want a new one.
Yes, they want a new car.
Mm-hmm.
That car has the most aeroplane wings.
Then she goes to car, aeroplane wings.
But that's not an aeroplane.
Mm-hmm. Show me yes. Again. Yes. Mm-hmm.
They're all packing their bags. Their mother has one bag.
Mm-hmm. What's about stories you are telling something?
Yeah, she writes stories.
Mm-hmm. She can create new stories, right?
Yes, she writes in her stories.
Mm-hmm.
She wanted to see Agra and the Taj Mahal, and all she wanted to see is.
Mm-hmm.
So she went to school and she was saying that she was very happy to go there. Her teacher told her to pack her school bag and go home because she was very ill.
Mm-hmm.
Then her mother gave her some medicine and let her go to Agra. Then her parents and she packed their bags and had a bath and went there.
Mm-hmm.
So she wanted to see the Taj Mahal very much because then she touched the statues and she touched the
mm-hmm.
pictures and the grills and the walls. She always touched them.
Mm-hmm.
Because she didn't see these houses like this and buildings and flats.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't see like this. So she was pleased to see her parents and all other grills.
Oh, mm-hmm.
So she looked at the walls and she just touched them and one big saucer came out.
Then?
Then her parents just went to another area in Agra. They went to one hotel and they were just goes in the Taj Mahal, but the Taj Mahal is very old.
Oh.
It is beginning to break. Then they went to some other area and they went to that one tower was there and they saw one Rajabhai tower. They went somewhere. In that place.
So she is talking about Rajabhai Tower in Bombay, Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is breaking.
She forgot about that saucer, but I don't know what is a saucer. Then can you tell me what's a saucer? Not that cup saucer, any giant saucer that.
What does she mean? Any idea? Saucer?
Sapnan mutha bagitlas kai saucer? Kai bagitlas?
That is how a giant was eating. There are skeletons, everything.
And then she started talking about skeleton.
Upstairs. And I told my parents that there are skeletons down. So I didn't know that what I saw is that. Yes.
Okay, good.
The giant was with a big nose, very sharp teeth. And very scary eyes.
I'm scared. And, no, don't tell them. I'm scared.
And very sharp and big and huge eyes.
I'm scared. Next time.
Don't be scared. I'm scared.
I'm scared.
Anyway, so at the fact level, we can think fear of animal, dreams of animal, but something very interesting at the sensation level. Not what she says, but how she manufactures stories and chains of stories. That was very interesting. Let me see. Yeah. I gave one remedy, China. I will tell you why. But just the follow-up.
No scary things. But she draws sometimes, she draws scary things.
What does she draw?
I draw a ghost.
Wizard
with the power in his hand. Any visit or anything is outside our house and...
Why you are saying like this?
Anyway,
this
child did fantastically well with China 1M, few doses. And one attack she had when she went to Pune and because of the gulal, immediately China took care. There was very good change. Once upon a time she stopped saying those long stories. She was narrating stories with morals. And what was my basis of prescription was following. The idea of sensation comes here. This was a drawing. There is no big baggages, nothing to do with Agra, nothing to do with London, nothing to do with skeleton, but how she was manufacturing story. So case analysis, theorizing, thoughts rapid and quick. Dreams of animal and danger, fear of animals, writing desire too. These were the rubrics. Understanding many desires, many ideas, fantasizes, lots of cravings for prawns, tasty food, etc. Stimulus hunger. This is typical sensation of Rubiaceae family. And if you see just this rubric only, forget Rubiaceae, just theorizing, thoughts rapid, quick. Dreams of animal, danger, fear of animal, and writing desire too. You will get China. So, just China 1M, one dose did the trick. This is called sensation. What is running through and through? If you just prescribe one or two rubric like fear of animals and belladonna or stamonium, that is very superficial. How does this child differ from other? She loves appreciation, but what was very peculiar was how she manufactures stories. Such a small child of 6 years, but chains of stories. This is Rubiaceae. This is theorizing. So, this was a short child's case, an example, how at sensation level we can prescribe. Fact level was fear of animal and the rubric. But sensation was lot of theorizing, lot of quick thoughts, gets bored very easily, wants some stimulus, wants special dessert, prawns, tasty food, etc. So, coming back to you, two more things I would like to suggest. One is, you should be a patient listener. whatever level you go, when patient wants to speak to you, just listen. This is a very important, very, very important hint. Something happens automatically at the seventh level. Patient wants to tell you, don't be judgmental, just listen. If you are a good listener, automatically case will start healing. And third is your confidence. If you have got confidence in yourself, if you know what homeopathy can do, that is projected. And do your best to help the patient. Whenever you are stuck up, concentrate on that, contemplate on that, where you are wrong, how to get better remedy, how to retake, how to solve the case. And above all, if you know the level of experience, you know where to go. You should not get lost into the stories. From stories, get the image. From image, get the level of experience. Experience in the image is sensation. And sensation, what runs through and through, will give you the remedy.